الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فيقول الله عز وجل في كتابه المحكم: قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة أنا ومن اتبعني وما أنا من المشركين. ويقول الله عز وجل: ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لعلي رضي الله عنه وأرضاه: لئن يهدي الله بك رجلا واحدا خير لك من حمر النعم، أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respected brothers and sisters, inshallah, today we are talking about dawah activities in Western countries like Japan. What is the role of Adda'i ilallah, the dawah worker? What are conditions he should be observing? And number two, Adda'watu ilallah, what are conditions related to Adda'watu ilallah? So our first point is Adda'i ilallah, the da'wah worker. And every Muslim among us should be a da'wah worker and should be trying to acquire those qualities and those characteristics. The first thing is to have knowledge, to have ilm, to know what is da'wah, how to invite and to how to do this work and carry out the da'wah. Because the very ayah I recited in the beginning, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرًا, I call the people towards Allah upon wisdom and knowledge and understanding. So that is the first condition to know and to understand the da'wah itself and deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, to understand the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to extend at least where he should be knowing the and understanding the fundamentals of deen. And al-halal min al-haram, wa-sahih min al-khata, what's right, what is wrong, what is lawful, what is unlawful. So if someone is coming to him, he or she should be in a favor to help them out in answering the questions and in satisfying their urge and their need. Number three, al-khuluqul kawim, a sound character, a good character, a very humble person who is always giving smile and who can give smile to the people. And this way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, indeed you have very high moral character and moral standard and merit and etiquettes and manners and characteristics. So that this is what da'i ilallah needs, to carry those characteristics. And he should be very soft in his conversation, in his talk, while talking, while calling people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number four, أن يكون الداعي على قدر كبير من الحرص على شفقة الناس. الداعي إلى الله, the da'wah worker, should be very kind, very polite, should be always open is just as hard for others, for the audience, for those who are surrounding him and who are around him. And this is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. If we didn't send you except as a rahmah, as a mercy and kind sign of kindness for the whole universe, and for sure the whole humanity is going to be the top priority. And this where Prophet ﷺ is teaching us, مَا كَانَ الرِّفْقُ فِي شَيْءٍ إِلَّا شَانَهُ وَمَا نُزِعَ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا زَانَهُ. Whenever his politeness and kindness and feelings of mercy were there, they are going to raise the status of that person. وَمَا نُزِعَ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And whenever it will disappear, this quality and this character, then it is going to decrease the status and height of that person and that character. And this is where this is coming, and we are coming to know that a person and a da'iya ila Allah should be very kind and soft in this regard, in this perspective. Number five is as-sabr wal-hilm. To have patience, to have tolerance. Because in Quran, this is where we see over and over, Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Imam al-Anbiya, the leaders of the prophets, and Imam of Anbiya is being told over and over what? وَصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا تَكُ فِي ضَيْقٍ مِمَّا يَمْتَعُونَ. Wasbir, you might show the patience. You must hold yourself, your feelings at times, your anger at hours. Audience may act in any given way. Or someone who is learning, a student, out of misunderstanding, out of ignorance, out of any other given reason, they might been doing something or acting in a way which is unwise one, which is unethical and unhealthy, but still a da'i ila Allah. If he has a lot of patience, and if he has a lot of patience and tolerance and sabr, so he can face those difficulties easily. And similarly, there are going to be multiple difficulties and multiple challenges in the field of da'wah, regardless if you are in the West or you are in the Far East in Japan. The same is true, for sure, a da'i ila Allah needs a lot of patience and tolerance to continue with the amal of da'wah and with work of da'wah, because it is job of al-anbiya wal-rusul. The very divinely selected people, they were not just common people, they were divinely selected people for this purpose and for this job. So if someone is going to now carry that job and that duty, for sure he has to have that much patience and stamina and tolerance and those qualities. This is where he should be enough able to carry out those activities and to meet the challenges of da'wah. Number six, سِعَةُ الصَّدْرِ عَلَى الْمَدْرُوِيِّينَ. He should have a wide chest, big heart, to meet the people, to help the people, to assist the people, to welcome the people. He should not be looking or serving a certain group of the community. He should be having wide heart, wide mind, broad-minded. Any Muslim and every Muslim, he should be welcoming them. Brother or sister, old age, young, children, anyone and everyone. Non-Muslims, yes. Because this is ad-da'watu ila Allah. He calling the people towards Allah. So there's no discrimination. the more he is going to show that love, that kindness, and that generosity, the more people will get closer to al-da'wah ila Allah and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number 7, al-ta'awun wa al-tansiq bayna al-du'at wal-maraqiz al-islamiyya wal-muassasat al-islamiyya. Another important point is to coordinate between and among da'wah activities, da'wah workers, and Islamic centers. This is what in most of the cases we are lacking. Any center we visit in most of the cases, any da'i ilallah we visit, any sheikh and imam, he looks like as he is driving the boat like a solo flight. Only it is him. When we are working in these societies, in these communities, we must think of coordinating the different centers, different organizations. A da'i illah should be bringing them together. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And that's going to happen through conversation, through talk, through al-khuluq and that conduct and character, through patience and tolerance, yes, through accommodating others and their mistakes. If we are to, we will be willing to open our chest and heart for that purpose, willing to coordinate and to understand that this is our purpose, to unite the community rather than to divide them, then we will be learning that thing and we will be practicing it. And this way Prophet ﷺ is reminding whom? Abu Musa al-Ash'ari and Mu'adh ibn Jabal, when he is sending them to Yemen as da'i ilallah, telling them what? Bashira wa la tunaffira, yassira wa la tu'assira, tutawi'a wa la takhtalifa. Bashira, you're going there to the people, you give them glad tidings, good news. When people listen to the message of Islam, they love it. They like to listen it. They like to come closer. They show willingness. وَلَا تُنَفِّرَا. And don't make them run away because of your attitude or conduct or your way of da'wah and your way of preaching. Then the second thing is what? يَسِّرَا وَلَا تُعَسِّرَا. Make the deen of Allah easy. وَلَا تُعَسِّرَا. Don't make it inconvenient, difficult for the people. If they listen to the talk, they understand, oh, well, this is the deen. It looks like hard for me to practice it. It should be other way around. يَسِّرَا. You make it easy for the people. Understanding of the deen and practicing of the deen in their day-to-day life. And تُطَاوِعَا وَلَا تَخْتَلِفَا. And most of us, we don't know it or we forget it. To cooperate with each other, to coordinate with each other, to help and assist each other. وَلَا تَخْتَلِفَا.